Okay, so this is how we extract honey. There's a few tools of the trade that we have. We have a knife and a capping fork. This is to collect all the debris, an extractor, and obviously the frames full of honey. So I'll start with the knife. Very carefully, because this first bit I'm doing towards me. Knife isn't actually that sharp, although it is sharp enough to hurt yourself with. And the idea is just to cut the white cappings off the top of the combs without disturbing the honey as much as possible, because that's you're losing the good stuff. Any bits you can't cut, go with a fork under the caps and flick it up off towards you. I've seen some people really good at this. I'll need that. Push it right under. But again, don't want to lose that good stuff. Now, I've obviously cleaned all this equipment thoroughly before use, dried it thoroughly because water is the enemy of honey. For saleable honey, the water content must be below 20%. Reason being, if it's sat in your cupboard with too high of water content, it'll ferment and then you'll have booze all over your breakfast. Some people like that, but maybe not for the kids. So that's both sides done. And that goes into the extractor. Now you can't just throw them in there willy-nilly. You see the top bars are to the outside where the force is going to be. Reason being, when the bees store their honey, obviously they can know where gravity is, so they store it at an angle so it's not going to drip down. So it's like that. You're going to maximize your return. I'm going to spin this now.